A lot of things going on in World Championship Wrestling, wouldn't you agree, Dream?
We're on the verge
of a big match here.
Yeah, let me tell you something that I got out of that. No, Nick Patrick is not the real deal Evander Holyfield.
No.
Because Holyfield has the heart of a lion, and he is a man of his word. Nick Patrick is got the heart of maybe a little kitten, if you will, and is not a man of his word. But it looks like something's brewing, but I know you were trying to drag it out of him. Speaking of dragging it out, here's the man himself, Diamond Dallas Page. He's on the roll, brother. He told the NWO where to go, right or wrong.
Well, he did, and I tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to talk to him in this program.
Good.
We need to ask him point blank, are you going to go or are you not?
Yeah, do that. Yeah, let me tell you what to ask him. Ask him point blank, are you a member of the NWO or not? Ask him that, like point blank, like right up, head up.
There's an echo in this arena here somewhere. All right, Diamond Dallas. I think Diamond Dallas is very upset. We saw the footage earlier about the NWO making him their eighth choice.
Yeah, and I'll tell you another thing. He was a little hot about him being the number eight guy in line with that thing. But bottom line is, there's so much going on. Hogan, no, will be in Nitro. We know that. We understand that coming up live on TNT, WCW's Monday Nitro coming up this Monday. But rumors are Roddy Piper, as far as I'm concerned, the man that started this fight, needs to come on and get on with this fight, will be there. What an explosive situation. And then, right after the mothership here on TBS, we are talking tonight. The Cable Ace Awards will be going on, and it might change the way producers, only you people out there by watching it can change the way they feel about wrestling. We should have long, long ago done had a lot of Cable Aces.
That's exactly right. You may not like the presence of the NWO, but at 9 o'clock tonight, they will be at the Cable Ace Awards on TNT. And by you watching that program, you will show television producers all over the world why professional wrestling has been consistently over the years.
Oh, I mean, really.
Cable's number one program.
Yeah. Well, we, you know, sometimes you got to toot your own horn. Toot, toot. And that's what we need to be doing. And Dallas Page, in the midst of controversy this past Monday Night Raw, as you've seen him turn around and give the old fadeaway kick to the midsection there to the Cheetah Kids, who used to ride with Zorro on television.
And a roll-up. One. A one count. He tried a lariat that time and an arm drag takedown. He used to ride with Zorro.
Yeah,
on
Cheetah
television.
Kid was a television star a long time ago. He's a big star now by being here, but whether he can get to the pay window again, one of the most devastating holds of the 90s, we're talking about the diamond cutter is another thing.
What do you think will happen? Now, I said the rumor very, very strong that Rowdy Piper will be in Nitro Live 8 o'clock this Monday on TNT. If he shows up,
what do you think?
Is there going to be a fight? Or maybe will we finally get the contract signed for this match of the decade?
Hopefully that's what needs to be done. But like I said earlier, and you conflicted with me a little bit, Piper never run away from a fight. And Hogan is where he's at because he's used to fighting and wrestling and doing all these things. I still go back and saying, hey, he walked in the desert and laid it on the line and filibustered with the man. I'm talking about Piper. So he needs to bring his kilts, bring his pen, bring his paper, bring his attorney, bring his lawyers, bring his manager, bring his agent, and sign this thing for the match of the century. Bigger things cannot be around the corner than this one right here. I guarantee you, this is big. Okay, that's the way I've you asked
Hogan,
me.
Hogan's been putting it out there, like you said, over the past couple of weeks. Piper's been listening, you know. The confrontation that we've been wanting to see, we've been waiting for, may begin this Monday, live on Nitro. You got to tune in, 8 o'clock Eastern time. By the way, you just heard what Nick Patrick said. He almost really agreed to a match. Here's a cover. He is back in the ring. Will he wrestle Chris Jericho if Jericho ties one arm behind his back? We are going to have that announcement, if it is made, tomorrow on WCW Pro at 5:05 Eastern time.
Yeah,
so make sure you tune in tomorrow.
Yeah.
And we'll let you know if that match is signed or not.
That Alan Sharp he's sharp on attack.
Isn't he?
I'm telling you.
Okay. Cheetah Kid.
Yeah. High risk that
is. How about that?
Dallas on the outside. Cheetah Kid now. To go to the pay window for him right here would be a major upset. Right here. A major upset. High risk maneuver.
Punch. Wow. The cat missed.
That's like if you're standing outside a cage, see that thing there, and you got some meat dangling at a cheetah, and it runs to get that meat and forgets the cage is there.
Yeah.
That's just what happened to him. He missed the high-risk maneuver.
That's good.
Well, yeah, that's good.
That was a good one.
That
one,
was good.
Two, and he yanks him up by his mask. Diamond Dallas. Little bit different attitude for DDP.
Well,
because what has transpired over the past couple of weeks with the NWO.
He's made his own bed, too. Let me tell you.
Diamond cutter!
Yeah. You can turn the lights out. Turn out the light. The party's over.
Here's a one, two, three. Next thing you know, you're going to be selling iced tea. The winner.
He didn't invent that. Willie Nelson invented that. Selling iced tea. If y'all are listening out there, I'm in the market for selling iced tea. Anyway, watch out here. The big hook is coming. Very simply put, diamond cutter, this is over. Go get him, Tony.
Here's the winner. Let's bring him in. Diamond Dallas Page. You know, as we head into World War III, and you talk about battle royals, this man has to be one of the odds-on favorites. You'll recall earlier this year, the winner of Battle Bowl. But be that as it may, Diamond Dallas, this past Monday, I think you were rather put out by the comments made by the outsiders wanting to join the NWO.
Well, I'll tell you, Tony, it wasn't the fact that I was picked number eight that really ticked me off. I was more ticked off by the fact that my good buddy Kevin Nash implied that because of my personal ties with Eric Bischoff, let me clear that up. My buddy, Eric Bischoff, who lives one block away from me, that if they came to me earlier, Hall and Nash, about being in the NWO, that I might have went behind their back and smartened up Bischoff. Well, you see, Kev, that's where you're wrong. Because DDP would never have done that. Page would never have done that. Because of my relationship with you and Hall is different than it is with Bischoff. I keep personal and business separate. What's good for DDP is good for me.
So what is good for DDP? Give us an answer. Is it yes or no? Are you going to accept being part of this new world order?
I'll tell you right now, I'm more agitated by the whole situation, and I think a lot of things got to be answered, and I think they'll be answered at World War III. Because at World War III, I am the odds-on favorite. And when I take all 60 men out, it'll be me and Hogan. We'll see what they want to do then.
Diamond Dallas, a lot of confidence, a lot of momentum going into World War III, and more Saturday night still to come.